I'm thinking of Romans 4:11 as a place to go for sign and seal language. He received circumcision as a sign or a seal of the righteousness which he had by faith while he was still uncircumcised. The purpose was to make him the father of all who believe without being circumcised, and who thus have righteousness reckoned to them. But in all of the rites of the Old and New Testament function precisely in this way. So this language of sign and seal, it looks like it's worth exploring, because this is why we define sacraments the way that we do. Signs emblemize as like a visible word the blessings of the gospel. They exhibit and they communicate. And seals are attesting and confirming of that which it actually seals.